And when Jesus saw all that would be accomplished, he was pleased.
Luke says that when they came to a place called the Skull, there they crucified him, along with the criminals, one on his right,
the other on his left. Jesus said, "Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they are doing."
The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him.
They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Christ, the God."
If he is the Christ of God, the chosen one.
There he was, held on the cross, with nails in his wrists and feet.
Before he breathed his last, committed his spirit into the hands of his Father, he cried out, "My God, Father,
why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me?"
Pierced, beaten,
bruised,
insulted,
abused, mocked,
ripped, torn,
rejected,
betrayed
by his closest friends in exchange for our peace,
in place of our sin, in exchange for our healing,
accused of living a lie when he was the truth.
But he offered no words in his own defense.
Did anyone really know what was happening?
But this is what God had in mind all along.
It was God's will to crush him and cause him to suffer.
And when Jesus saw all that would be accomplished by his anguish, he was pleased.
Christ died for sin, once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous.
And God so loved every face, every name, every heart.
And God so loved every life that he gave Jesus his one and only son
to die a death that we deserve to die.
Our mortal life in exchange for his eternal one.
But his death was only the beginning.
Jesus died so that we would be slave to sins no more.
So that he could rise up, and so can we.
So today, Jesus is alive. And we are free.